students for fifth semester BCom, IFRS. Okay, I have a question. In the year 2017, they have asked for 14 marks. For 14 marks, they have asked two questions, A and B, subsections. In that first question, I will read out the question. Just have a look at it. The statements of financial position of Kirti Limited and Murthy Limited as on 31st March 2017. See, the closing date of the year is 31st March 2017. If closing date is 31st March 2017, definitely the opening date would be 2016. Right? So, then what else is given is, the balance sheets of two companies, Kirti and Murthy Limited, share capital, shares of 10 each. See, when you see, there is 1 lakh rupees of share capital in Murthy Limited. Okay. See, when we have given 2 years or two companies balance sheets, we should look at only the Murthy companies, because here Kirti company is purchasing the shares of Murthy Limited. Kirti company is purchasing the Murthy company share capital. So totally, how many shares we are purchasing and all those things, we'll see later. So totally, here Kirti is purchasing and Murthy is selling. And in Kirti, Murthy's company's balance sheet, we have 1 lakh rupees of share capital. And each share price is how much? 10 rupees. Then how many shares we will get? 10,000 shares. Am I right? Now I'll read further. There is a general reserve of on 1/4/2016. See, when there is a 1/4/2016 date is given. See, the beginning of the date is 1/4/2016. No general reserve will exist. Okay, on 1/4/2016. Definitely, that would be coming from the previous year. That is, last year's closing balance will be the opening balance for this year. So, the last year's general reserve will be coming this beginning of the current year. And also, profit and loss account 1/4/2016, even that is also of the previous year. So, last year's closing balance will be as an opening balance for the current year. And profit for the year 2016-17. See, 16-17 is current year profits. It's a current year profits. Then what else is given? Is given accounts payable. Then assets, tangible fixed assets, investments, 8,000 shares of rupees 20 each in Murthy Limited. See, we have totally how many number of shares in Murthy Limited? 10,000 shares are there. Then Kirti is purchasing how many shares? 8,000 shares. See, when Kirti is purchasing 8,000 shares, Murthy will be left out with how many shares? 2,000 shares. So now, if you strike off these three zeros, okay, two ones are, two fours are, so the ratio will be 4:1. That means, after purchasing, Murthy's company's paid up share capital, more than 50% they have purchased. More than 50%. Am I right or no? Yes. Then, definitely, Kirti company will have 4/5 share of in all profits and reserves. In all profits and reserves. Then, this will be the first step for us, like calculation of
ratio.
Then what is the second step? We have a second step of calculation of capital profit. Right? So now when we find out capital profit, we should understand what is capital profit. Once again, see, any profits or any reserves which is standing on or before of the purchase date. So, what is the purchase date here? If you read out the last paragraph, Kirti Limited acquired the shares in Murthy Limited on 1/8/2016. That means, in between this date, 1/8/2016, Kirti company is purchasing Murthy company's shares. That means, whatever the profits which is standing before 1/8/2016, which all will comes to where? Capital profit. Whatever the profits which comes after 1/8/2016, which all goes to revenue profit, that is current year profit. Right? That means, what is capital profit here is, when Murthy is doing a business alone, alone, that alone profit all will comes to what? Capital profit. Whatever the profits or reserves which is earned by Murthy along with the Kirti after purchase, that will come to the revenue portion of the profit. Got it? Now let us understand what is capital profit here. In this, first we have general reserve as on 1/4/2016 is given clearly 40,000 rupees. And we have a profit and loss account also on 1/4/2016 which comes to 15,000. But there is a profit and loss or a profit from 1/4/16 till 1/8/2016, we can take it as 31st of July 2016. Am I right? So from April to July, how many months it is? April, May, June, July. 4 months it will come. So the total profits earned during the year is 2 lakhs. Okay. In that, 4 months profit will be how much? 66,667. Right. Now, this is the profits which is earned before purchase of shares by Kirti Limited. Am I right or no? Yes. Now, when you take the totals of this, you will get 1,21,667. This is the profit which is earned before the purchase. Before the purchase date. When you earn before the purchase date, then also Kirti will have 4/5 share and Murthy will be having only 1/5 share. Now let us know what is the 4/5 of Kirti and what is the 1/5 of the Murthy portion. Okay, now on 1,21,667 into 4/5, 1,21,667 into 1/5.
97,334.
This is
this is
24,333. What about this?
97,334.
So this is the capital profits which Kirti will get after purchase, and this is what the Murthy will get. Okay. Now after this, we have a third step. What is that? Calculation of revenue profit. What is revenue profit? The profits which earned after the date of purchase. See, from 1/8/2016 to 31st March 2017, whatever the profits or reserves which is earned by together Kirti and Murthy together, they were earned. See, there is no reserve as on that, as on 1/8/2016 and later after. Am I right or no? So that means there is no general reserve as on that date. But there is a profit and loss, profit of from 1/8/2016 to 31st March 2017. The total profits earned for the financial year 16-17 is 2 lakhs. From August to 31st of March 2017, how many months it is?
8 months.
What is the 8 months profit? It comes to 1,33,333. Am I right? So in this profit also, Kirti will have 4/5 share, Murthy will have 1/5 share. Tell me how much?
10,666.
1 lakh?
1,6,667.
1,6,667. No problem. Okay. What about this?
26,667.
Or 63. 66. Okay, wow. So this is revenue profits earned by Kirti and Murthy. Now let us see what is the minority interest or non-controlling interest. Calculation of non-controlling interest. See, what is non-controlling interest? After Kirti purchases Murthy's business or capital shares, how much is the amount left to Murthy? How much share capital left to Murthy? how much capital profit left to Murthy, how much revenue profit left with Murthy. We have to find out that. So in that, 1/5 share capital of Murthy Limited. See, how many shares are left? 2000 shares are left. And one share price is 10 rupees. It comes to how much? 20,000 rupees. Second, 1/5 share of capital profit. What is the capital profit portion of Murthy? Is 24,333. And 1/5 share of revenue profit of Murthy Limited is 26,667. We'll take it as 67 only, round off it. So it comes to how much? 71,000. This is called as non-controlling interest. So what is the question he is asking? From the above details, calculate non-controlling interest. We have calculated. We got it. So don't do extra part of it. Understood? So if you do this much, how many marks you will get? 6 marks you will get. Fine? Please take it.